mathematicians never die. They just lose their functions.
Called us here to discuss theorems, not to tell tricks.
I found it quite amusing.
That is because you are a child.
You didn't think my equations were child.
I'm sorry, we interrupted you.
Thank you. I can't tell you how much I appreciate you all being here, even if you weren't originally excited to come. Mr. Newton?
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Mr. Bernoulli. Mr. Lopi.
You mean Guillaume Francois Antoine Marquis de l'Hôpital?
French.
On to the meeting. There is something I really want to discuss with you. Just some ideas I've been playing around with. 1 divided by 0. An enigma of an equation.
Expression.
What?
It's an expression, not an equation.
He's right. Be quiet.
Okay, back to the board. 1 divided by 0. What does this mean?
Nothing?
Not nothing. It's undefined. It does not exist.
I apologize. This is what I meant.
Then be more specific.
Undefined. That's the accepted theory today. It's impossible to divide by zero, so it just doesn't exist. But what if we're looking at this the wrong way? What if the answer is incredibly simple? If we could solve this equation, imagine what we could do. Imagine the new spheres we could open up in computer programming and engineering if we could just fill these teeny tiny points on the graph. Now to explain my theory. You have to just go with me on this. When we are first taught to divide, we learn that division is putting one thing into a number of groups. For example, putting 4 apples into 2 groups.
This is ridiculous!
Gentlemen, please. I know you're much more advanced than this, but we have to make things as simple as possible. So, 4 apples into 2 groups is 2 apples in each group. Yes?
Yeah.
4 divided by 2 equals 2. Now, we want to put 1 into 0 groups. If there are no groups, then we have nothing. So 1 divided by 0 equals 0. It's that simple!
I would like to roll over in my grave now. You can't use mere logic to find the solution to such a controversial issue.
As much as it pains me to say it, I agree with Mr. Newton. We have all considered the possibility of this proof. Why, when I was developing my proofs for integrals and differentials...
Excuse me, you were developing your proof? For differentials and integrals?
Yes. What are you implying, Mr. Newton?
Your proofs that you developed all by yourself without any glances or transcriptions at someone else's papers?
Not this! Mr. Leibniz, Mr. Newton, please sit back down. We don't have time for debates. Okay. My first theory didn't work. So let's go on to the next possibility. Maybe we're thinking about this in the wrong way. Going back to apples. This 1 is an apple. You can divide it by, say, 2. And then you have 2 apple halves. But if you divide it by 0, then what? You can't cut something into 0 parts. Your knife just doesn't exist. Therefore, 1 divided by 0 is actually 1.
Are you hungry?
What? I don't know, maybe a little.
You just keep talking about apples.
Oh.
Mathematics is more complicated than fruit.
But I was talking to my teacher the other day, and she said... What? What now?
She?
A woman teaching math?
A female mathematician.
It is absurd! Women can't do math!
Why not?
Well, it's just not good for them.
It's downright dangerous.
It would make their heads explode.
Well, I do think it can make basic concepts clear if you describe them in terms of apples.
Of course you like those apples, don't you?
Excuse me?
One fell on your head, so you say. Inspired your theories of gravity, so you say. It's all a myth. But you get fame for the story, fame for creating calculus, you just take it all!
Gentlemen, please, we don't have time for this.
I took the credit. I slaved over those theorems for years. I didn't eat for days. I didn't sleep for weeks, holed up inside my study, churning out numbers after numbers after numbers. Sometimes it felt worse than crafting the Principia. I gladly handed my papers into the Royal Society, believing them to be in safe hands. I was wrong. I never could have predicted that a little rat would go rifling through my work, stealing my discoveries, only to slap on new notations and pass them off as his own.
I may have seen a glimpse of your papers, but that was after I had already perfected differentials. You could not possibly believe that I would take a mound of illegible scribbles when I already had my own clearer, simpler notation. Why, just ask L'Hôpital.
You mean Guillaume, Francois, Antoine?
Your book! Where is it? I know you're on my side. Where is it?
You just carry copies around, don't you?
One must always be prepared to defend oneself. You never know how violent men can be until they disagree between fluxions and differentials.
Go on, read it.
I must hear in justice own that the learned Sir Isaac Newton likewise discovered something like the calculus differentialis.
Something exactly like, I would say.
But the method of Mr. Leibniz is much more easy and expeditious on account of the notation he uses, not to mention the wonderful assistance it affords on many occasions.
I rest my case.
You mean this isn't clear? This?
Mr. Leibniz, I'm sorry, I admire your work, but I have to side with Mr. Newton on this.
Him?
Yes.
An Englishman?
Yes, I know this must be a blow to you, but I know what it's like to slave over your numbers, forming new ideas and theorems, only to have them ripped away from you and published under someone else's name.
Now I really must step in.
No, you are the guiltiest one here.
You signed a contract. I hired you as my tutor, and you willingly agreed to let me use any of the discoveries I came to as a result of your teaching.
You must be kidding. I discovered the so-called L'Hôpital's rule myself.
Child, don't inflate your head any bigger than it already is. I credited you in my book.
You briefly mentioned me in your book, in an extremely condescending manner.
I will not stand for these insults.
And I will find myself in any alliance with the Swiss.
You brought me back from my peaceful rest amongst the dead for this?
I am Sir Isaac Newton.
You just don't understand.
I have another idea. What if the answer isn't a number? 1 divided by x. As x gets closer to 0, y keeps getting bigger, stretching past the borders of this graph, here, closer to infinity. What if 1 divided by 0 equals infinity? Could it be that simple?
I'm afraid
That's not possible. On the negative side of the graph, as x gets closer to zero...
y stretches farther downward past the border of the graph to negative infinity.
It's impossible for there to be two different solutions.
I agree with all of you on this subject. Only on this subject. Mm.
So it still doesn't exist. I'm sorry, this has probably been a complete waste of your time. I actually thought I had it.
Never erase your work.
But it doesn't mean anything.
Don't assume the question will remain unanswered. You may be the next Newton.
Or the next Leibniz.
Or the next Bernoulli.
Or the next Guillaume Francois.
You perhaps intend to steal my condolences?
S'envole une chanson. Elle est née d'aujourd'hui dans le cœur d'un garçon. Sous le ciel de Paris marchent les amoureux. Leur bonheur se construit sur un air fait pour eux. Sous le pont de Bercy, un philosophe assis, deux musiciens, quelques badauds, puis des gens par milliers. Sous le ciel de Paris, jusqu'au soir, vont chanter.